everyone. Nice to see you this evening for you, this morning for me. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. I gave a recital last night, a live stream recital, and so I'm a little tired this morning, but I'm really happy to see you here, and I'm happy to work with you, and I can't wait to hear all of you sing. If I had one thing to talk about in opera, it would be what I consider the most important thing for an opera singer to have, to do. And it would be, it's funny, I ask my students, I say, what is the most important thing in opera? I get so many different questions. And I've boiled it down to the most important thing is to be heard at all times. Because if you have learned in opera perfectly, if you've gone and lived in Florence and learned Italian perfectly to sing Don Pasquale, or let's say, or Don Giovanni, and your Italian diction is perfect, and your voice is, you've worked on everything you can for your breast support and everything, and all of a sudden the audience can't hear you, then that, none of that matters, as long as you have to be heard at all times. That's the most important thing for me in opera. So that's what I really want to work on today, is the consistency of a vocal phrase continuing on without anything interrupting that phrase, either making it above too loud or too soft to interrupt the phrase from being consistent. So that's kind of my jam, really. That's how I like to talk about opera. That's what I like to accomplish with my students. And so let's get started. I'm ready to go. Sam, are you starting? Samuel, this has been a long time coming for me to finally hear you sing.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
Should I go ahead?
Yes, go right ahead. There it is.
Bella si come un angelo in terra belle grido, fresca si come il giglio, fresca sul mattino, odio che parla e ride, sguardo che mi porta con cui te ti doma che vince le mano sorriso incantator sorriso incantator.
All right, Samuel, one sec, great time. All right, and then we got to the middle section. That's fantastic. All right, good job, good job. Okay, so Samuel, I want to introduce to you the idea of something. I know you've heard me talk about all of these things before, but it's nice that I'm able to work on it with you one-on-one like this, or one-on, how many, 71? Because there's 71 people in here, so don't be nervous. All right, so right now what I hear when you sing is you listening to yourself a lot. And what I get is it's an idea that a lot of younger singers do because they want to do so well. I know you want to sing so well, and you sing sort of lips backwards so that you can hear yourself really well. Now, what we're gonna try and turn around in 15 minutes is for you, instead of singing lips backwards and listening to yourself, you have to start singing by sensation rather than listening. So rather than listening from here back, you hear the echo of your sound, and that gives you the confidence to realize you're singing outside, lips forward is the idea, okay? So before we begin, I want you just to say ah for me. Will you just say ah? Like ah. Ah, like you're speaking.
Ah.
Yeah, very good. Ah. Say it on different pitches. Ah, 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 ah. Different pitches, Sam. You're like yes, very good. Very good. Now, that, first of all, I also love the way you're opening your mouth right there. That's a very good open, relaxed jaw. And well, anyway, I can't see your jaw anymore, but can you hear me?
Yep. All good.
Great, great, great. As long as you can hear me. All right. Now, would you, with that same sort of placement, sing, just let's actually, and so this, that's the placement I'm talking about right there. Forward, ah, ah, ah. Now, if we could, let's break this down into quarter notes, okay? So every syllable is going to get a note like this. Bella si come un angelo. All right? Give it a shot.
Bella si come un angelo.
Now, in order, like at the beginning of this thing, I said the most important thing is long, beautiful phrases not being interrupted. So I need the consonants to be smaller, okay? We've talked about this. So everyone who hasn't seen me or heard me before, I came up with the idea of intelligently lazy diction. And in order to achieve that, you have to be both intelligent and lazy. And this is what I'm talking about here. So I'll do all of the double consonants in Italian. But then the other ones, like the single consonants, like S for siccome, I won't go siccome. I'll go siccome un angelo. So very quickly is where the consonants are. Try again, Samuel, with very quick consonants, except for the important ones.
Bella siccome un angelo.
Okay, everything was good, but you closed the O vowel. So I want everything in the same place. Bella si come un angelo. All right, try again.
Bella si come un angelo.
You're closing the O of si come. You're going si come instead of si come.
Come.
One more time. Come. Si come.
Si come.
No, you're closing that O. Do you hear it?
Si come. Si come.
Si come.
Si come.
Better, better. It's still a little close. You're affecting the sound. And that's the point. It's like I'm trying to get you to just have a free sound just flow right out of your head. One more time. Say it for me, every syllable. And we're at, watch that. Oh. Bella si come.
Bella si come.
Okay. You're singing. This is what you're doing. Bella si come. I want bella si come. Okay, great.
Bella si come.
No, you're still going.
Bella si come.
See,
Bella,
say, oh. No, just don't sing it. Say it. Like we say, what happened? Yeah, exactly.
Oh.
Right there. Do it.
Bella si come.
No.
I
know, it's very hard, but this is the exact point. Right now when you sing Cole, you're listening to yourself. And I need that sound outside of your head right now. Si come.
Si come.
Yes, sir.
Si come.
Yes. Do you feel the difference?
Si come.
Yes.
Yeah, I felt that.
Okay, that's where I need you to sing. Okay? Once again. I got you right here.
Bella si come un angelo.
Now, okay, very good. Now we need to do this with a forward sound without raising our larynx. Because before you had no problem with your larynx, and now you're raising your larynx a little bit as you go up, okay? So I need it to be the sound always coming out. I want you to do two things. I want you to take your hand, place it here on your chin, put your finger here, and I want you to place the sound on your finger, okay? You're not pushing here. You're just placing your hand, okay? Try again. Here we go.
Bella si come un angelo in terra pellegrino, fresca si come il giglio che s'apre sul mattino.
Very good. One second. Samuel, very good. That's exactly what I'm talking about. I hope everyone is hearing the difference between the one before. And the thing is, the one before might have sounded okay in your room there. But I guarantee that as soon as you step onto an operatic stage and you go, "Bella si come," like that, the sound will die in the pit. And the point is to put this laser beam on the sound by going, Bella, and placing the sound out really as far as you can, so it becomes, it's like when you have a water hose and it goes out a little bit, it just goes long like that, and then you put your thumb on the end of the water hose and it spurts out very fast. That's what you're doing with your sound right now when you do this. Now we have to be very careful as you go up, you relax this neck, okay? I don't want any sort of larynx raising and or anything at all. I'm hearing just a little bit of that as you go up into your middle range, okay? So I want to start the second verse real quick and try again. This is a good one too. Let's start it with speaking, actually, if you don't mind. One quarter note for every syllable. Al-ma-i-no-che, okay?
Al-ma-i-no-che-n-ten-gen-wa.
Gen-ten-gen-u. Everyone gets a quarter note, every single one. Okay, very good. All right, everything was, everyone, I'm sure you were listening at home, you heard everything was in line except for the U. The way we do U, and again, that's very common because it's a closed vowel. So U, Samuel, is no longer U for you. U is O with rounded lips. Okay, I'll show you the difference. Do you hear how it goes? Here's what it sounds like the right way. And I'm singing O with rounded lips. Try again. Very good, good. All right, now speak it with it. Almaino.
Almaino chen ten chen oa.
Better, a little more rounded lips, because okay, so we have to trick everyone into thinking we're singing ooh without singing ooh. Again, and we have to put a little more of the intelligent into the lazy diction, okay? So that was very close. That's the direction, though. That's the direction, Samuel. Very good. One more time. One more time, Samuel. It's somewhere in the middle there, but let's sing it, okay? That's back. No, that's lips backwards. I want lips forwards. Ah, say ah three times and begin this phrase. Say ah.
Ah, ah.
Yes, that's it. Add a little bit more support than you have for ah. No. Very open throat. I like the open throat. But what you're missing right now is the forward placement in the sinus cavity. Okay? So I need the combination of all three resonators. Oh, Samuel, did you go away again?
He's there.
Okay, good. It's just a video. That's fine. So, say ah three times, a supported ah, Samuel, and then begin this phrase, all right? Very good, Samuel, one second. So everything was good except for the ooh, okay? Again, remember that ooh is not ooh anymore, it's O with rounded lips. One more time. Samuel, I didn't hear any difference. I didn't hear any difference for that ooh. Ooh is O with rounded lips. Say Genua. No, you're singing
Genua.
Switch the word. Say Genoa, like Genoa, the place in Italy.
Huh?
Say Genoa.
I didn't hear that last part. What was it?
Say Genoa.
Genoa.
Exactly. Now round your lips around that sound.
Genoa.
Exactly. That's the sound. See,
Genoa.
Boom, exactly. That is right, okay?
David, please.
David, nice to meet you.
Hi. Nice to meet you, too. How are you doing?
So well. I'm having trouble hearing you.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, it just got better, whatever you did. You just got closer, I think.
Yeah, I just got closer.
You're singing Rodrigo, right?
Yeah. I'm doing Rodrigo's aria, Per Me Giun.
Great. I got my score back, champ. All right, I'm ready for you. Let's hear it. You need a key?
I actually got a backing track.
Great.
Okay.
Sonio mio caro, uscir tu dei da questo rendavel. Felici ancorioso, si abbracciar ti possio, io ti salvo. On when qui dirci, con when qui dirci addio, o mio Carlo, per me giunto il di supremo, no mai più.
Beautiful accompaniment track. So, David, what did you pick this for? What made you pick this song?
I like the plot setting where there is you have a friend who's willing to take his life for you. So it was more of like an emotional something that you could pour slowly yet gracefully into a cup. Something that you can channel. So I felt that maybe out of personal experience or just the aria that spoke to me.
That's beautiful. I really like that. I love that the story says one thing. Anyway, let's dig into this. So the main thing I hear with you is you don't have vibrato consistently. And that's what I want to work on with you really hard. Because when I say the words vibrato, I am also saying the words breath support. And when I say breath support, I am saying vibrato because they are one in the same. Uninhibited air creates a natural vibrato and you should have vibrato every second. So if you don't mind, I'm gonna turn you into my punching bag for a second and I'm going to make sure you do have vibrato on every single note of this aria. And it's gonna be hard, but the point of me doing this is that so when we're done working together, you will be able to hear, oh, I didn't have vibrato on this, okay? So let's begin vibrato every second because vibrato is life, vibrato means energy, vibrato means you have good breath support, okay? Here we go, we're gonna go from this. I'm gonna give you all the notes. Per me giunto.
Per me giunto.
Very close. Did you hear the tall, straight tone? Even okay. The small notes are the hardest ones to have vibrato on, but that's why you have to concentrate even harder, okay? All the way through, okay? You did it again. Did you hear it? Concentrate on those. Start again from the beginning. I'm gonna going to give you a present. It's my first present I've given out all day. It's called your vibrato hand, okay? I want you to take it, and I want you to spin it like this, and this is going to remind your body to have vibrato. As you sing the phrase, to help you with the phrase,
per me giunto il Dì supremo.
Said it again.
Non mai.
Okay, and continue on. Here we go.
Per me giunto il Dì supremo.
Again, reset. Go again.
No mai più ci rivedrè.
Very good. Again, David, the little notes did not have vibrato. Ci and ve vedrè. So you had the vibrato of più ci vedrè. Okay. And also, let's do a breathing exercise real quick. What do you do to warm up your breast support?
Mostly I think I find lip tilt good, but
Bravo. Good answer. I have something else.
Lip tilts, that's it, I guess.
That's okay. I'm gonna give you another tool to really warm up that breast support. It's really easy to do. I actually do this before I walk on stage every time. Right before I walk on stage, this is what I do to make sure my support is really on point and ready to go. It's very simple. You breathe in and out through your mouth as quickly as you can, then move the breath to your nose as quickly as you can, and end on a hmm. All right, here's what it is. All right, give it a shot. I want to hear this. I want it vigorous breath. I want to hear you. I don't want it to be, okay, vigorous. I want to hear it. Nose. Very good. Now consistently. Watch me. I don't want you to move to your nose till I point to your nose, and I don't want you to say until I point to you, okay? Okay. Start with your mouth. Look at me and make a sound. I want to hear it, audible. Right now you're going, I can't hear that. I want to hear your breath. Yeah. Start with your mouth. Very good. That's better. You feel that, don't you?
Yeah. This part heats up a bit.
It heats up. That's exactly right. And that's warming up right there. That's warming up. All right. Everybody who's listening, all other 70 people, you can take that and try that at home. If you're sitting at home by yourself, give it a shot. It really works. You're going to be amazed. All right. David, it's funny. Just by watching you, I could tell that it was a little higher. I'll show you. Your warming up was your breath was a little higher than I want it. Just for the future, I want it really down low. Okay. Right now, it seemed like it was a little higher, and I want it here. Okay. This is where it needs to be. When we're talking about breath support, we know what we're talking about. All right. Try it again. Here we go. Let's see. We got to there. Ci congiunga Dio. Let's go from there. Vibrato every second. That's why we did the breath support.
Can I do the hand as well? I think that really helps.
Of course. The hand is yours to have forever. You're welcome. You can send me a thank you card. All right, here we go.
Hold on, let me start again.
Chi.
Chi congiunga Dio.
Try again. Oh, those are the hardest ones. Slow it for now. Slow down the faster notes. I'd rather you have vibrato and it be slow than for it to be a tempo and no vibrato, okay?
Ci congiunga Dio.
If you need to slow it down, slow it down. I want vibrato every note. That means you have breast support every note. When you don't have vibrato, David, it means you're holding something in place. You get your jaw, your tongue, your throat, whatever it is, you're being lazy with your support, whatever it is, you're holding something in place. And I'm trying to get this free flow of sound coming out of you. Again, like I went back to the beginning of this whole session, I said it's all about making a beautiful phrase that is uninterrupted. That's the key in opera, okay? One more time.
Che congiunga Dio nel ciel. E che premio Gesù fede.
You had it until that note, you straight tone. Did you hear it?
I felt it.
You felt it. That is the most important thing. That's why I'm beating you up so bad right now. I want you to feel these things so that then you can go into the practice room and be like, ah, I didn't have support there. Okay, let's go from here. One more time. Fedad. Okay, one second. With vibrato, it's important to have on the fast notes. You also have to have it on the onsets. So right now you went straight tone, no support. So then the vibrato becomes the trill. I'll show you. A little bit like that, kind of like that, right?
I can try that for sure.
Try it. All right, better. All right, we're moving on. No, what is this? Three flats.
Hold on.
Sorry, here we are.
Sul tuo ciglio il pianto io miro, lagrimar
cos... Oh, so close. You were great until lagrimar la. Straight tone. Okay, one more time.
Lagrimar così perché.
Great. Okay, David, I want to tell you what this is helping. This is helping your pitch right now. A little bit when you started and you weren't on the support all the time, it tended to be a little flat in places, like you weren't right on the center of the pitch. When you sing with vibrato and breast support every second, you end up being right on the center of the pitch, because the vibrato is sustaining you, okay? This is really great, okay? Were you gonna do this into Carlo Ascolta?
No, okay.
All right, good. All right, let's get to the end of this. Lagrima no faco, no faco, estremo spiro lieto, aquí morra, perché no facor. Let's start from no facor, okay? So we got.
No facor.
Onsets, David. We start with vibrato, we finish with vibrato. We start with support, we end with support.
No facor. No facor, no facor, l'estreme.
Well, here's the pitch. Try again from there.
L'estremo spiro, le tue occhi.
No. Okay, with vibrato. And you reset your vibrato hand. So, lieto e aquí, we're over here.
Morra.
Okay, morra. Let's start from there.
Morra per te.
Good job. Way to keep the vibrato through. That's all right. That's all right. Great job. Okay, so David, just concentrate on the onsets with vibrato and concentrate on the little notes with vibrato, okay? And other than that, I honestly, I have to tell you, I think you should be singing Se Vuol Ballare by Figaro. I think you should sing that. I think it's too soon to be singing this. I'll tell you, I'm 42 years old. I'm singing my first Don Carlo in April. Okay?
Yes. So.
Maybe it gives you an idea of this piece, but this piece is pretty advanced, okay? So yes, I'm not sir. Saying you can't do it for fun. What's that?
I will take your recommendation.
No, you don't have to. I do what you like. I want you to enjoy this because you had such a beautiful reason for singing this piece. I loved what you said. It struck you in the heart, and that's important. But maybe listen to me sing it for now and then sing Se Vuol Ballare, okay? I think you could do Se Vuol Ballare really well, okay? Anyway, talk to your teacher about that, you know? But anyway, David, thank you so much. It was really nice to meet you. I'm happy I've heard you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
You too. Bye-bye. Nice to meet you, Jemima. I'm Lucas.
You too. I'm Jemima.
Nice to meet you. All right, where are you starting with this? Are you starting right on the Casa Riva part?
Yes, I am. I'm just going to skip the introduction part because it's a little long.
It is long. Let's hear Casa Riva. Fantastic.
Sorry?
Oh, I just said it's a beautiful track. You have it with full orchestra? That's amazing.
Thank you. Okay, I'm just gonna start. Yeah.
Start it up. Sorry I interrupted. Fantastic. So, talk to me. What made you choose this piece?
I chose this piece more because of the technical issues that I had with it in the first place. So, when I first heard the song and when I learned about it, I just want to take it up because it's a challenge and to most sopranos and.
Yeah, and you wanted to take on the challenge.
Yeah.
I love that. You wanted to challenge yourself. That's a beautiful reason to sing a piece. So there were some interesting breaths that you took in the piece. And I'll tell you why you have to take so many breaths. It's because you're not fully on your breath support. And it's the same thing that I talked about with David before you. Is that you need to have vibrato every second. When you sing with vibrato, your Sound has vitality. It has life. And right now, you started the entire first phrase with zero vibrato, straight tone completely, which means you're under supporting and you're holding the note in place. Okay? So I need, I'm going to sing it down the octave because I'm a little tired from my recital yesterday, but right now I'm getting straight tone. I need from the very second you start, vibrato, vibrancy, life in this sound, okay? Let's start with that, okay? Vibrato, I need you to unencumber your sound and let it just flow freely, okay?
Okay.
I'll give you my second present of the day, and it's the same present I gave David. If you want, it's a vibrato hand. And you just put it in front of you and do this to make sure you have vibrato, okay? Here we go. Let's work on this D vowel. I like an open E vowel, but it needs to be a little more E. So it's tall in the front. It's tall in the back for I, and then it's E in the lips. So instead of E, it's Eva. Try again.
Should I slightly close my lips for that?
Yes.
Okay.
Costa D.
Okay.
Instead of day. The tongue just comes up a little bit, and the jaw closes a little bit for diva. Actually, let's do like we did with Samuel. Let's speak it. Costa diva. All right.
Costa diva.
Very good. That's much better. Absolutely. That's where you need to sing your E. Okay. One more time.
From the.
You got to start with vibrato. Very good. You have your score there? Do you have a pencil?
Yes.
Okay. Costa diva. That's your breath, okay?
Yes. Okay.
Let's try it there. And the thing is, once you energize your breath like you are doing now, you're going to realize that you have more air to sustain through because you're controlling the air rather than letting it pour out of you, okay? And honestly, I need a little bit more support from you. I need about 10% more support. So Jemima, I want from the beginning, I need a little bit more support. I need a little bit more sound, okay? Let's try it again from the top. One more time. Let's just see what happens. Very good. The only note that didn't have vibrato, study. And because of this is an exercise now, I want vibrato in every second, even star. Those little notes need it, okay? Try again. 10% more support than you're giving. I need a little bit more. I know it's supposed to start softly. I just want to hear it, okay? I want to hear your voice. Here's your vibrato hand. Use it. Use your hand. There you go. I want a vibrato hand from you. Here we go.
Sorry.
One more time. Good ear. Try again. Very good. You made it through, but you straight toned the last three notes. Try it again. Costa diva. Breath. What? What?
It's hard to focus on the vibrato as well.
I know. It's so hard. But I'm giving you this so you can practice, okay? Here we go. Don't forget your breath. Don't forget your breath. One more time. So beautiful. So beautiful when you do that. Yes, exactly. Keep doing it. Let's go on. Here we go. You didn't take a breath there, so I was prepared to stop you, but you took the breath there. Good for you. Here we go. So the point of taking that breath is that you get enough breath to finish the phrase. So take a good breath there, okay? And I need, honestly, when you were singing that, you had vibrato, but I needed a little more support, okay? I need you to energize this midsection here a little bit more, okay? It's like you're riding on a motorcycle or something. Have you ever ridden a motorcycle before?
Yes.
Okay, do you know that feeling where it goes like that?
Yes.
That's what you want to feel in your belly, like, okay? Here we go. Questa.
Questo sacre, questo sacre a te che piante.
Breath.
Oh,
so close. Did you hear it? The straight tone, straight tone. Okay, one second. You changed your vowel for the ah. Every other ah you've had has been ah, and this one is onte. I want nice, bright, forward ah, okay? Il bel sembiante. Speak it for me, will you?
Il bel sembiante.
Biante.
Biante.
Much better. Okay, here we go. I need that onset. You're kind of, Jemima, you're kind of creeping in. I don't want you to, and then be on support. Il bel. I want you on your support from the beginning. Okay, here we go.
Il bel.
Again, you're doing that vowel weird. Bio is what I'm hitting instead of bia. Try it.
Okay.
Biante.
Il bel sembiante.
Much better. There we go. Here we go. And at the very end, you went, son, straight on, bell. So close. Really beautiful. So here's where you have to go. That's what it is. So make sure to take the breath where that comma is. Do you see this? Do you see that?
Yes.
Okay, so. piante, il bien biante. So good breath there, good breath. Okay, very good. Let's go on. I'll take it. Okay, the reason we're not getting through that is because of the support is a little under. I just need a little bit more support. Go back to the very first one of that. Again, we have to start, the onset has to be on the breath, okay? Okay. Start on the breath. Okay, one more time. Very good. That was the best phrase you sang all day. That was fantastic. That was so well supported. That's the amount of support you need on Costa Diva. Do you feel that amount of support?
Yes.
That's what I wanted the whole time. And now that you found it, let's go back.
Okay.
Here we go. I want that support right here, okay? No vibrato, no onset. That's again. Yeah. You got it. You can do it. Think about it. Here's your vibrato hand. Okay.
Go.
I want everyone at home that's listening. Hold on, I'm leaning on my piano. Everyone at home that's listening, there's a huge difference between that first sound and that second sound. The second sound is full of life. It's full of vitality. That is where your sound is, Jemima. Every second when you use vibrato, it sounds so beautiful. When you have support, it's perfect. It's exactly what you need. You just have to get over the habit of not having vibrato or support, okay? Because I said, like I said before, vibrato is the same as me saying support. Support is the same as me saying vibrato. I could say one or the other, and you just need to hear which one you want it to be. All right, so brava, beautiful singing, really gorgeous voice, and just keep working at it, okay?
Thank you.
It's nice to meet you. Just one second, I'm pulling up the music. Are you doing the recitative beforehand?
I didn't get you, sir.
Are you doing the recitative beforehand?
Okay, I could do that.
No, I don't want it. Just whatever you want. Whatever you have ready, I'm ready to hear.
I'll sing it once and then you can stop me where you feel like I need improvement.
Well, great. I will. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Hey. What a beautiful piece of music, right? I can see why you chose this. But tell me in your own words, why did you choose this music?
I think I've always had a problem emoting what I sing. And this piece, when I sang it, I think that was the first time I actually felt like, I understood the lyrics really well. Yeah. I mean, I had read about it and I read the meaning.
Yeah.
Also because I started learning Italian recently and I'm really fond of it. So I thought of choosing this. I thought of choosing this piece.
That's wonderful. That's great. And I'm glad you're working on Italian. It's a very important language to know. All right. Sorry, I've got my iPad here and it's just giving me fits. Anyway, I want you to start it again, please. With me just playing. Okay, great, great, great. So what I'm hearing with you is that when you want to support, you support, and when you don't think about it, you don't support. So what I really want to work on is keeping that support consistent so that every time you breathe, it's a nice deep breath and we're really on the breath right now, okay? Because right now it's a little out of control when you sing it. As far as like where the sound is going and how it's being supported, okay? So are you standing up or are you sitting down?
I'm sitting down.
I don't want you sitting down. Right. I want you to stand up, back up, and move the camera however you need to so you can stand up.
Okay.
Now take your time. Take your time. This is important. This is important.
Is that better?
Yeah, now back up about about a meter.
1 second.
If you can.
Yeah, I just a minute, I'll figure this out.
No problem, take your time. I'd rather have you standing. That's gonna be, you know, a part of this issue, you know? All right, very good, very good. Now, I want you to take a nice full breath and I want you to exhale it on a s for me, okay? Okay, I can already see, hold on 1 second, 1 second, 1 second. When we take a breath, we don't move anything, but here, I'll show you. I'll put my hands here and show you the breath. So the breath, when we take it, it fills up this way, like that. So it's not this. It fills from the bottom to the top. I'll show you. I don't know if you could see that. Let me.
I could see it.
Okay, I'll just do it one more time for you. So it goes from the bottom to the top, okay? And this, nothing up in your chest or shoulders should move. I took a real deep breath just then and nothing moved up top, okay? Try again. Take a nice deep breath. I want you to exhale on a s. All right, very good. I want this to be the meanest snake in India. I want it to be really like the worst, biggest snake in the whole world that's ever existed. And I want to hear this. I want a vigorous, important, big, proud sss, okay? Okay. So I'm doing this on purpose. I want you to sss until I tell you to stop sing, and you're going to feel like you're going to die. And then I want you to feel the breath you take after you feel like you're going to die. Because that is where your breath, pay attention to that breath, okay? That is a true breath. Let go of the s as long as you want, and do not breathe until I point to you, and trust me, okay? Bend your knees and just bend your knees a little, make sure we're not gonna pass out or anything. S, exhale on a s.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hold it.
I don't care. Okay. I don't care about this. I care about the breath after it. Just trust me. Run out of breath. I want you to be like, run out of breath. And then all of a sudden you take a breath. I just want you to feel that sensation. Do it for me one time and trust me. Okay.
I get what you feel.
That is a different breath than you've been taking. Okay? That's where I want the breath to come from. That sort of exaggerated. All right, try now just the breath. Just the breath. Already better. I see it. Your shoulders are raising just a little. I'm okay with that. But before they were this. I just want it nice and easy, okay? Now let's do it again. Exhale on a s, and then when you're running out of breath, take another breath naturally, okay? Here we go. Very good. Now the breath. That's it. Okay, that's the breath, and that's the amount of support I need for you to have when going. Okay? Here, let me get the music back up. Here we are right here. Sound is much better. Now I need the vibrato to be consistent. Right now you're holding it back. I don't want you to hold it back. I want you to let the beast out of its cage and let it roam free on the countryside, or at least on the 71 participants here. All right. Very good. You have a beautiful vibrato. It's fast. It's old timey. I love it. It's beautiful. Don't be afraid of it. Okay. Try again. I don't care that it's written piano either. I want this at least mezzo forte for the time being, okay? Sing it out. Take that breath. Did you hear kio? Kio pianga? You went kio pia. So that means when you straight tone, you're not on your breath, okay? I need from the very beginning. Not sha. And then you're on your breath. On your breath, the onset needs to be really on your breath, really secure, okay? One more time. Nice. Good. Trust.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. No, it's fine. Don't be afraid to make a mistake. Here we are. Here's the pitch. Support. How does that feel? Talk to me about this.
Feels much better. I can hear the difference.
I hope you can. I know everyone else, all other 70 people in here can as well. Really beautiful, beautiful. That's exactly what I need for you to do. Okay, great. We're going to move on here. Liberta. Okay.
Could you give me the key again?
Sure. One second. So right now, that was under-supported compared to where we finished. And the reason is because you didn't support the first note. Really, you set yourself up for support, Shalaka, by supporting the first note. The first note is often the most important note, because once you get that right, it's easier to get everything after that right, okay? I wanna also say, when you have a note that's a higher note that comes up and there's a lower note before it, you have to add extra energy to the note before it. So you want to energize the A before the K. So it's so you energize that note and it becomes a springboard up to the note that makes the note coming after it easier, okay? So more energy on the A. Very good. You straight tone the first spi. I need everything in that vibrato. I need everything in that support. Again, vibrato equals support. Support equals vibrato. Okay. Not enough. Okay. Okay, support that note. Again, no problem. It's because I kind of was halfway stopping you. Again, so it's Eke Sospiri. Eke. I know that's not it in Italian, but with support, we need that idea that the bam bounces you up. The second time again, bam, bam. Okay? So it needs that springboard action. A little faster in the tempo. It's a little slow right now. Here we go. Vibrato every second. One second. I want you to double this tempo, okay? Eke sospiri, eke sospiri. Okay? This tempo right here. Here we go.
Eke sospiri, eke sospiri.
That's exactly right. Very good. Very good. So, that is how easy it is. Now you just have to make it easy at half that tempo, okay? But that's where it is. Wah, 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 wah. Okay, I need that line. Right now I'm getting bum, 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 bum. Okay, let's try it one more time. Oh, you heard the speedy straight tone. One more time. I need vibrato there. Otherwise, you're holding it. One second. Now that note was a lot easier, right? Because you energized the note before that note. That is the key right there, Shalaka. I'm telling you, that's going to be so good for you. Okay, I want you to start again the second verse. Sorry. I want to get into something. So with all this handle music, I would be remiss if I didn't mention my main thing again, which is intelligently lazy diction, okay? Because right now I'm getting la sha kio pianga, and that is so many consonants that I don't want to hear that don't help you at all, okay? So I want la sha kio pianga. All right, can you speak it like that? Very, so that the mouth relaxes and hangs open, the jaw is nice and open. As a matter of fact, let's do this. Take your hand and place it right here. Exactly, and so that these consonants are just, you know what, never mind, that's not even a good one. Let's do it here, let's go here. Two hands here. La sha kio pianga. All right, try.
La sha.
Do you see, you watch, look at your jaw. You're going, la sha. La sha, watch me. La sha. See, you don't even have to close your mouth for la. La 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 la. Look, my mouth is open. La 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 la. Try.
La sha.
Nope. You went la sha. Blah blah is what I'm getting. La sha. Okay. Try.
La sha.
Yes.
Yeah. Was that
is it. That is intelligently lazy diction there. I understand what you're saying, but you're keeping the line nice and long and free, okay? Because right now the consonants are kind of doing this to your line, and you need this, okay? Now with that in mind, let's sing it like that. Hands here, here we go. Hands here. That was exactly right, except the vibrato on Kyo. Did you hear Kyo Pianga? You straight toned that. One more time. Going on. Dare I say, that's the most beautiful phrase you've sung today. It's not perfect because, again, we can't sing like that all the time, okay? Which I understand. But it's important to understand the relaxed nature you need to have in your jaw and the small consonants that come along with that. Then that makes a beautiful long phrase, okay? Shalaka, we've gone over time now, but thank you. It's a beautiful voice. You can really, the more you concentrate on this, you know what? Never mind. Hold on. Before we go, I want to hear the high note with you doing the exact same thing because, la dura sorte. Here we go. Hands back, we're going to do the same thing. I want to hear La Dura Sorte. And then go on. Okay?
La Dura Sorte.
Great. If you're going to do that, one second. If you're going to do that, I need vibrato up there, okay? You can't just go, ah, it's a ha, sweetie. Okay, here we go. Good. This is the direction you need to go. That is the amount of support you need. That's so different. They're recording this. Go back and watch it again. Watch how you started and felt that support, and watch how this support is here, okay? This is going towards the amount of support you need. You might even need a 5% more than this, okay? But this is the right direction, Shalaka. All right, this has been really great. Nice to meet you. Thank you for singing.
Nice to meet you too. Thank you.
Nice to meet you, Fiona. I have the whole entire Messiah here, and I have to get to the page that this is at. So 1 second.
It's towards the end.
Yeah, I know. I don't know how to jump pages in the Foursquare
app. It's just before the last chorus.
I know, but I don't have the score. I have my iPad, so I have to click on this. Okay. Anyway, tell me a little bit about yourself. Why did you choose this piece?
Well, the text is really powerful, and I don't really have great breath control, so I thought I'd work on the long phrases from this aria.
You know, it's important to know your weaknesses so that you can turn them into strengths. Really, that's really great. I commend you for working on that. Anyway, what else? So, what other repertoire do you sing besides?
It's mostly just arias from. I've not sung any operas. It's Elijah. I've sung one from Elijah, and Rejoice from Messiah. I've done that also.
And, nice. Yeah. So handle.
Yeah.
All right. I think I'm there. If God be for us, who can be against us?
If God be for us, who can be against us? Who can be against us? Who can be against us? If God be for us, who can be against us? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? Of God's elect?
Very nice. You have someone playing for you?
Yeah. Yes.
Hey, bravo, whoever it is. Very nicely played. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, and beautifully sung. Okay, I have to tell you what I love about your voice, Fiona. But do you go by Fiona or Faith? I thought I heard someone say.
Fiona, it's Fiona.
Fiona. You have such a great placement to your sound. It really, you just comes out of your voice, out of your mouth, and it's just out there. I love, you place your sound way far out here. Great placement. I can tell that you're right. We need to work on a little bit of breath support. And remember what I said, breast support and vibrato are the same thing for me, okay? Well, mostly the same thing until you get to a little bit more advanced. But right now, let's think of them as the same thing. When you sing with vibrato, unless you're creating it with your throat or neck or your tongue or something, you are normally singing with support. So let's attempt to do what I did with David. Let's put vibrato into every single note that you sing. And this is going to be tough in the beginning, but you're going to get there, okay? Here.
If the Lord be for us, against us.
Did you hear any straight tones in that?
Yeah, Lord.
Me too. Okay, let's just do if God be for us, stop. Let's get that far, okay?
If God be.
If, onset. If.
If God be for us,
that's all we were going. We were just going to for us. If God be for us, stop. Okay? Try again.
If God be for us.
Oh, good. Now, I want you to take out the consonants. I want you to sing, ew. Actually, let's just sing it on ah. Ah, okay? Vibrato, is what's your favorite vowel to sing on?
It's ah.
All right, great. I picked right. Let's sing it on ah. You hear all the straight tone?
Yeah.
I'm going to give you the third gift of the day. My vibrato hand. Here you go. Take it. It's yours. All right, take your hand out. You know the music. Put the music down. You're singing it on ah. Put the music down. Here we go. Now this is your vibrato. Okay, here we go. All right, now I need the hand to have vibrato, which is this. Right now you're going, you're just putting your hand out in front of you. That doesn't mean anything. Okay, one more time. Those were three straight tone. That's okay. I need vibrato. Here we go. Very good. Here we're going. Going on. Oh God, your placement is so perfect. All I need is a little bit of that. Really, the placement of your voice is incredible. I just need that vibrato behind it. Because you're doing it in the right way, but it's not under your support. We're going to do actually what we did with Shalaka a little bit, okay? I want you to take a breath, and I want you to breathe out on a okay? Keep going. Very good. Keep going. Take a breath. You feel that breath. That's the type of breath you need. And do you feel the support you have when you're going? All right, I want you to breathe out on a. I want you to breathe in and then start this phrase. And I want the same support for the as on the ah, okay? We're not gonna put the words in. Ah, okay? Breathe in, breathe in again, ah, and sing with the same support. Here we go, here are the pitches. Breathe in and.
I didn't get to it. What should I do and then start?
Yes, exactly. Breathe in, let all your air out on a s, breathe, and then sing on ah.
Okay.
Good. 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 Breathe. Very good. Do you feel that's the amount of support you need? That's it right there. Okay. So whenever you're having trouble and you're in the practice room by yourself and you're kind of going through music, breathe out on a am I using the same amount of support? You literally can just go yeah. Okay. That's the amount of support. Cause right now it's You hear, that's off your breath, okay? Yeah. Not using your full support. So I'm giving you the tools now to understand when it's happening and when it's not. Now, the freedom comes when you use your breath support well to now allow the vibrato to happen. And that's the next step in this process, is you need to allow this vibrato to happen. Right now, you're holding it a little bit. So would you do me a favor? I want to relax your neck just a little bit. Let's take our neck and just roll it back and forth, shoulder to shoulder. Okay, not backwards though, not backwards. Just shoulder to shoulder here, okay? Like this. Very good. Now let's lift your shoulders. Let's give a few shoulder rolls like this. Very good. Oh, you're very relaxed in your shoulders. All right, it's not your shoulders where we're fighting tension. Now I want you to relax your jaw, and I want you to shake your jaw like this. Okay, your jaw is very tight. Let's give your jaw a little massage. Very good. And now take your hands and pull it down like this. Not physically, just, yeah, that's a relaxed jaw. Let your jaw open. Leave it there. Leave it when it opens, leave it where it is. You keep closing it. Don't close your mouth. Yep, leave it. No, you, okay, hold on, one second. Fiona, you're doing this. I want this, watch this, ready? Okay. Yes, good job. That's a relaxed jaw. Now, shake your jaw. No, oh, you gotta open your mouth so that it, watch mine. It goes all over the place. Try again. All right, now stick your tongue out and give a shake. Pretty good. Okay, so a good way to relax your tongue is to take the tip of your tongue like this. Watch, I'll show you. And put it on your bottom teeth and stick your tongue out like this. All right, 1 second. So tip of your tongue against your bottom teeth. Like that. Yeah, and stick your tongue out. Well, exactly. So, well, kind of. No, okay. So the tip of your tongue is on the bottom of your teeth, and you don't stick your tongue out of your mouth because your tip of your tongue is there, but you just stick your, I'll just show you close up. So your tip of the tongue stays on the bottom teeth, all right? Yeah, that's it. Okay, very good. Okay, that's a relaxed tongue right there. Good. All right, so we've shaken our tongue, we've shaken our jaw. I feel like you have a little bit of jaw tension, and you're holding some things in place, okay? So I'm going to show you the perfect way to find position, okay? So I'm sure people have said, Fiona, open your mouth and sing ah. You need to open your mouth. And they say, yeah, open your mouth. First of all, it doesn't work like this. This doesn't move. Your teeth up don't move. So you think, okay, I'll open my mouth this way. That's not it either. What the space needs to come from your back molars, right here is where you open. And a great way to find this, everyone at home who's not asleep or smoking a cigarette, pay attention right now. Try this while you're at home because it's really good, okay? Take your finger and put it under your ear right here. Show me. That's it. Now open your mouth as wide as you can until you feel a pocket form. Do you feel the pocket? Close, that's too far open for ah. When you close your mouth a little bit and the pocket closes, that's how far apart your molars should be for ah, okay? So find the pocket, then close the pocket, then hold that space and sing this for me, okay? Pocket, no pocket, sing. Oh, gosh. Find it? No. Find the pocket first. Find the space. Keep your mouth in that space, okay? Okay, very good. That's exactly the space. Don't forget, that's the amount of support. Okay? Find the space. Where is it? Here it is. Now support. Very good. One more time. Now vibrato every second, okay? Okay, support. I want this at least mezzo forte, okay? Find the pocket. Okay.
it was different. I don't sing like this. Yeah. I don't sing with this much support. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's what you said in the beginning. So that's what I wanted to work on. All right. Okay. So very good. So this is, I've given you the tools now to find the proper mouth opening here so that now we can sing. If God be, sorry, I don't have to pull the music up on my iPad. Here we go. If God be against us. So we have now a vertical open mouth. So right before you were sort of, if God be against us or for us, against us, let's hope he's not. If God be for us, like this. And now it's, if God be for us, okay? Now let's speak it like that for me, please, on a quarter note. If God be for us, okay?
If God be for us.
Take your hand, put it here, and now speak it.
If God be for us, who can?
Very, very American accent, or when you sing this, you're doing for us. I want for us, okay? For us. If God be for us, okay?
If God be for us, who can be against us?
Very good. Now let's sing it there. Before you sing it, exhale on a s, and then put your hand here and sing, okay? Great job. Keep going. This is the amount of support you need. The exact same support you're feeling now is what you need when you begin to sing. Put your hand here, take a breath, and sing.
If God be for us, against us.
That's exactly right. How does that feel?
Yeah, a lot better.
It's different, I know. It's different, I know. But once you start to get this and practice this in a practice room, you'll take off. I tell you, Fiona, you'll take off. This is going to be really good for you to have these tools, okay? And that's what I wanted to give you in this time. Rather than work on the whole piece and hear the whole thing, I wanted to give you tools so that you can help yourself, okay? So I hope I've done that. And it was really beautiful hearing your voice. And really great. The placement of your sound is so perfect. Don't change a thing about that, okay? It's just the support and the vibrato we need, okay?
Okay.
And that relaxed jaw position.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. Nice to meet you, Fiona.
Thank you. You too.
First of all, the vibrato is a natural occurrence in the voice. It happens naturally when, as the chords come together, they create vibrato. So the only time you don't have vibrato is when you're holding something in place. Fiona had a little bit of jaw tension, and I think that was holding back her vibrato. So as soon as I got that unlocked, you heard the vibrato start to spin out. So as long as you place yourself in the right position and you have proper support, vibrato should happen. So I'd say rather than focusing on vibrato, like learning how to make vibrato, you need to make sure that you're relaxing, your jaw is relaxed, your tongue is relaxed, your throat is relaxed, your shoulders are relaxed, your neck is relaxed. And when you end up relaxing everything, it sort of happens in a natural way as you support and you just allow air to flow naturally over the chords. If I had to say there's one thing you need to have vibrato, it's really strong support and foundation of your breast support. That needs to be really strong, because the more you lean on that, the more vibrato happens. I'll show you. So I got, so as I support more and more, my vibrato becomes more intense. And when I'm under supporting, I don't have vibrato. It's just straight tone. So you need to concentrate on your support system, and that's where the vibrato will come from. Whenever anyone talks to me about range, I tell them to work on their middle voice. Because from your middle voice, you can extend up and you can extend down. But the stronger your middle voice is, the more likely you'll be able to move up and have a stronger upper voice and a stronger lower voice in any direction. So just don't worry about high notes for the moment. And if you're college age right now, you should be working on your middle voice. And as strong as you can make your middle voice, you should be able to eventually sing high notes. But you don't want to leave this good middle section until you're ready with this. This is the foundation upon which high notes are built, and that's your middle voice, okay? So concentrate on that more than popping out some random high notes, okay? When I was younger and I sang a piece that was very emotional, I always went way too far with the acting, and I didn't let my voice tell the story, because sometimes you have to back off and know that the composer did a really good job. Because let's take, Ach, ich fühl's, you know, Pamina's aria, where she's talking about how she'd rather die than be, you know, without love. Rather than going, ach, ich fühl's, es ist verloren, you know, instead of doing that, you have to just let the music speak and sing beautifully. So if I had any advice for you, it's just trust the composer and trust the music and concentrate on spinning a beautiful phrase and putting the emotion into the voice rather than creating an emotion. Because a lot of young singers try and go way too far. And so it's hard to find that middle ground though. But try and find the middle ground between emotion and good singing, and in there lives beauty. And trust the composer. That's what I'd say. Breast support. Breast support's number one. Absolutely, it is the engine that makes the voice work. And without it, you really just can't sing much of anything, you know? And so concentrate on having good support. And I'm not talking about over-supporting or under-supporting. I'm talking about a good amount of support. And you're gonna, if you're learning this now and you're working on your support, you will over-support, you will under-support, but slowly those two corners will come together and you'll be closer, you'll get better and better, and slowly you will come to find the perfect amount of support for your voice, all right? And that takes years and time and practice. Don't overdo it. Don't overdo it. Well, here's the thing. Everyone knows themselves well. If you're shy and you normally don't do enough, do a little more. If you're overly energetic and you're one of those go-get-em people, do a little less. And it's all about finding the middle ground. Really, the middle ground is right where so many things in singing live. I'm not over-supporting. I'm not under-supporting. I'm not placing it in too dark of a space. I'm not placing it in too light a space. I'm not overacting. I'm not underacting. I am acting, okay? And that's where it lives. Let the theater live in the voice more than you jumping around on stage and being crazy, I'd say, okay? So if we're, turn my piano back on. So here, if we're gonna go, let's do here. So as I approach my passaggio, which I'm assuming that's what you're talking about with registers, I'm thinking of one thing. Well, I'm thinking really three things. So, but the most important thing is I'm going to begin to think of vowel modification. And the vowels that modify are all the open ones. Ah modifies to E modifies to I, and E modifies to or schön, the word in the German word schön, O umlaut. Okay? So as I go up, but it's very gradual. It's a very small percentage of vowel modification. So vowel modification is one thing. I'm thinking the jaw opening, like I said here, find that perfect ah position. The jaw opens more and more, and then I lift a little bit here as I go higher. So I don't even have to sing it to show you the position. Here, I'll pull this up and show you. So if I have an E natural, which is where I start to cover, I have ah. It becomes a little more exaggerated, the mouth and the lift here as I sing up. And this is what that would look like. And then as soon as I get to the E flat, I'm back into pure ah, if that makes any sense. So I'm sorry, it's really early in the morning here and I haven't warmed up a bit. I had a recital yesterday, but that's the idea behind it, okay? I like to do an exercise up to a ninth. So it's like that. And then I get up to the ah. And then I know here on the E natural, I'm gonna begin to cover. So it's So you heard that 1% up on the top. It's very gradual. Now I go up here. No. G just the top note has a little ah. Now here both are gonna, because it's gonna be, this is gonna be ah, and then ah. You'll hear. And then as we go up, we continue to add the cover, add the vowel modification, open more, and lift here. Okay? All right. Oh, that's a great question. Okay, first of all, practice it this way. Hold on, I don't want to lose her in the chat. Practice it this way. Sing I don't know why Così fan tutte jumped in my head. It's the most random aria, but a fast. Stop. Take a good breath. Practice feeling what a good breath feels like. Se trambiazza qualche ragazza, te con quella cerca minare. So take the time to do a good breath, then slowly bridge that gap. So finché la vino calla la testa, una gran festa fa preparare. Se trovi piazza qual, then bridge it this way. Finché la vino calla la testa, una gran festa fa preparare. Se trovi piazza. So then you know how to do it, and you can slowly arrive there. Again, the middle ground. All right, slowly arrive there that way, and then also a trick of the trade is making sure you cut off the note that you need to take a breath for a little soon. So I got finca la vino, calla la testa, una gran festa fra fa preparar. So I'm not going fa preparar. I'm going fra preparar. Se trovi piazza. Do you see how quick I make that cut off? It's very quick to cut off, so I have time to breathe and come back in a tempo. Support. 100% support. Breath support fixes breathiness. If you're singing with a breathy tone, you need to work on your breath support like we did with, Fiona. We did with Fiona. Exhale in that sort of thing. It's like breathing through a straw. That's how you work on breath support, okay? And then breathe with that same amount of support. You have to learn to feel the sensation of proper support. When you're doing that, memorize the feeling of and then have the same exact support when you sing, okay? Breath support. It all comes back to breath support, doesn't it, Andre? Breath support is just so important. It comes back to breath support. Great question. I kind of touched on the register thing. It's a gradual switch, okay? And the thing is, well, you know what? Never mind. It's a very advanced technique. I won't talk about that. Okay, so let's talk about this. If you have two options when you're singing, one is a very forward option, like the most 100% nasal, and then a 0% or 100% pharyngeal, which is sort of mouth space. I'll give you an example. So, and then, if those are my two spaces between light and dark space, I want to be about 66% to 72% bright. So I would always err on the side of and not ooh, ooh, not that sort of sound, ooh, not that covered sound. You begin to cover in the passaggio, but for normal singing, err on the side of bright space and carry that space up. It's okay if you don't cover now because you're young. You don't have to cover. You can carry up like a You can carry it up if you want. That's normally where I would cover. I'm fine with that. You're at a young age, and eventually you learn to cover. And you learn to cover, but don't worry about it if you're not there yet. Keep it bright, light and bright and forward, okay? Okay. When you're in your higher range, your support increases. So you literally, it's like you've jumped onto a Harley Davidson and your support is bouncing underneath you. So an idea, it's both at both extremes, actually, of your range. You want to, the idea is that you're bouncing your support. You're bouncing your vibrato. So, as I go down, I'll do it down because I'm getting a little tired. If I weren't bouncing, here's without. And I can't get very low, but here's when I bounce the vibrato. Listen. My support is doing this, like that, okay? So that's the idea. At your stage, I would stick to Mozart like David, I told him, I think the Verdi was a little big for him right now. Like I said, I'm 42 years old. I'm singing my first Don Carlo in 21. I'll be 42 singing my first Don Carlo. I sing my first Verdi at 35. So take your time. You have lots of time. Sing art songs, sing leaders, sing chanson, sing Handel, sing Mozart, sing Rossini. Maybe Donizetti. Maybe Puccini. But don't push yourself too far, okay? There's lots of beautiful stories and beautiful songs that are written that are a little more suited for younger voices. And I think that's all the questions. So.